Hello and a very good evening to all our viewers. I am Piyush Rai, and with us we have today General Secretary to the Hostel Affairs Board, IIT Guwahati, Mr. Narayana Kumar Patro.
Namaste.
And after all the wonderful promises that were made by him almost a year back, let's see how much of it is he able to walk the talk today as we go live at Campus Broadcasting System, IIT Guwahati. So, Mr. Patro.
Yes.
What were the situations within the Hostel Affairs almost a year back, which kind of provoked you into taking things in your own hand, into giving this or getting this realization that you need to take this one for the student community and stand for the position of General Secretary, Hostel Affairs Board, IIT Guwahati, which we do realize is truly a challenging task.
Yeah, the my seniors who were the ex-post HAB Secretary, all they were also doing very good job, but I decided that I should go to this HAB General Secretary contest for it, because I was, before I was the mess convener of Brahmaputra Hostel. So in that, when I was mess convener, I learned so many things, and I felt that this could be done by a HAB General Secretary in a better way, and I felt that if I could be in that position, I can do it. Okay, I had a good popularity because my work was appreciated by my hostel and other hostel people also, that I am doing a good job and that. So I felt that I should go for HAB General Secretary and should do my best, mm-hmm. instead of staying outside and complaining, criticizing all right. things. I felt that it is my duty that I should go to contest in that post and do my best.
कोई ऐसा specific सा वाक्य आपके नजर में है जब आप जब mess convener थे और आपको देखा कि यार ये चीज सही नहीं हो रही है या यहाँ पे कुछ गड़बड़ है और अगर मैं इस position पे आ जाता हूँ तो मैं कुछ help कर सकूँगा institute की student community की.
मैं जब mess convener था तो बहुत सारे students basic menu system और ये सब के बारे में जो भी हम मेस कन्वेनर ये सब ऊपर तक कंप्लेन देते थे तो हैब से कुछ भी रेस्पॉन्ड नहीं मिल रहा था तो और हम भी जो प्रॉब्लम ऊपर तक कम्युनिकेट कर रहे थे तो उसका कुछ ज़्यादा रेस्पॉन्स नहीं आ रहा था तो मुझे ऐसा फील हो रहा था कि हैब सेक्रेटरी जो है वो इतना काम नहीं कर रहे हैं और ये फील हो रहा था तो इसलिए मैं हैब सेक्रेटरी बना था और बनने के बाद मैं देख रहा हूँ कि हैब में बहुत काम रहता है और कहाँ कहाँ पे टाइम जाता है और ये होता है जितना हम आसानी बाहर लेकर सोचते हैं कि इतना हैब्स काम नहीं हो रहा है मगर हैब में अगर हॉस्टल एक चल रहा है तो उसमें जितने भी होता है सारे काम हैब के अंदर आता है
बिल्कुल
सडनली कभी भी कुछ भी काम हमें पड़ सकता है हम सोच भी नहीं सकते कि आज ये हमारा हम अगर प्री प्लान करते होंगे कि आज हमें ये काम करने वाला हूँ तो सडनली नहीं होता है कोई दूसरा सडनली फ़ोन आ जाता है और पूरा दिन भर उसी काम में हमारा चला जाता है
बिल्कुल तो अब तो आप सेक्रेटरी बन गए हैं बहुत सारा समय भी निकल चुका है सो व्हाट टेक अस थ्रू योर जर्नी ऑफ बीइंग जनरल सेक्रेटरी टू द हॉस्टल अफेयर्स बोर्ड हियर एट आईआईटी गुवाहाटी
या आई लर्नड अ लॉट बाय बिकमिंग दिस हेड सेक्रेटरी एंड दैट हाउ टू मींस व्हाट इज एक्चुअली इन प्रैक्टिकल फील्ड व्हाट आर द प्रॉब्लम्स विल यू फेस when you become a secretary and when you what are the technical problems what are these because when you work it with administration because HAB secretary is just a bridge between the student and this there are secretaries at the hostel level and the administration there we are just a bridge connecting those so when I became this so I had so many things that we should do this we should do that so when I went to approach and fulfill my promises and all these things then I felt the real problem and where the time goes actually so okay. I have tried all these things and many things in my I have succeeded in something and I have failed in something right. and still some have been approved and yet it hone wala hai abhi kuch samay mein to ye sab chal raha hai aur bahut kuch sikha hu HAB secretary banke kaise diplomatically kaise apna kaam ko hasil kiya jata hai aur ye hai how to get it how to achieve our goals
क्योंकि भाई इंडिया है तो ब्यूरोक्रेटिक बैरियर्स के बिना तो कोई काम होता नहीं है
हाँ उन लोगों का थोड़ा प्रिजुडिस ये रहता है
यस माय नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज अ फॉलो अप ऑन दैट एक्चुअली सिंस यू नो वी वांट टू अंडरस्टैंड हाउ हैज इट बीन डीलिंग विद द एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन हियर एट आईआईटी गुवाहाटी व्हिच वी डू अंडरस्टैंड इज प्रीटी रिजिड इन इट्स ओन वे एंड स्टूडेंट्स फेस अ लॉट ऑफ ट्रबल एंड इट्स नेवर अ केक वॉक टू गेट समथिंग थ्रू द एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन हियर एट आईआईटी गुवाहाटी Also, like 2006 का 16 का जो initial period tha, there were all sorts of things happening, and there was this some sort of mistrust between the student community and the administration. Yeah. So tell us
there
about that.
There was a strike of Brahmaputra students also going to director's office, all these things. That has been highly controlled, and now the situation is very...
Controlled from which end? From students' end or from administration's end?
No, it was controlled from administration's end. The situation is far better now. The quality of mess food and the... Now, the neither the mess workers are near nor tortured and nor exploited. Neither the students also are getting a far better quality of food, all these things.
Are they?
Yes.
Have you taken a reportage on the same?
Yes.
Did you get the reviews from all the hostels? Abhi toh 6 mahine se zyada ho gaya aapke tenure ko, toh, has there been a change?
Yes.
If you take
survey, the food quality last year and this has been increased. But still, the main problem which are there, this basic menu system, people are expecting a different menu system because
we'll get back to that later. For now, tell me, it's almost like it's the last quarter of your tenure now, right?
Yes.
So what kind of decisions or initiatives that you took would you consider to be a milestone, not for yourself, not for your tenure, but for the student community?
Yeah. I have taken several steps which are very fundamental, and it will solve the root cause of this problem actually. The maintenance section, when what was happening, the main problem with the hostels was maintenance problems was getting delayed a lot. The students used to complain, and the maintenance problems used to not be solved. What was the problem, I'll tell you. There was no say of student affairs section or HAB in the maintenance issues. The maintenance issues were totally handled by maintenance section, which comes under Dean IPM, all these things. Okay, so what used to happen, although the caretakers and wardens and HAB chairman and HAB general secretary and all the hostel general secretary used to give so much time in writing applications and approaching, but still there was no... that much feedback, the results were not good. So this time we have strongly put, I had done a survey of all these things, and my all the hostel general secretaries helped me a lot. Hostel caretakers gave me what are the pending maintenance problems in different hostels and still not solved, although they have been following up with the maintenance section. So we have strongly put forward, I and HAB chairman, in the SEC meeting, and we have made a committee in which director has given approval also, that a committee will be formed in which the student affairs and HAB will be having a say in all the maintenance problems, and all the maintenance people have to report it to student affairs.
So can you give a little idea on what kind of composition this committee jo aapne banaya hua, what kind
this,
of composition
in this HAB chairman is there, Dean IPM is there.
Student representatives mein kaun?
Yes, vice president is there, and I am the HAB general secretary, the convener of that one.
Okay.
And they will decide and what is the problem and what should be the structure, everything.
Okay.
In which we have to propose how the student affairs can have a good say in this one to improve the situation actually. If this happens, believe me that there will be
a huge change in the way the things are handled, and the speed, of course. And so your maintenance cell is known ki saalo bhar pehle ki request ab jaake solve hoti hai.
They too have some of their limitations actually.
We would actually want to understand what kind of limitations, since you have been in close contact with the people at the administration.
Yes.
And we do know that at few times they really want to help us, but they have their own hands tied up. So we want to understand what actually keeps them from doing their work.
Yeah, so much pending works has been piled up, and the budget also is a problem. The central government has decreased the budget and those things. That has a direct effect on our improvement. There is the central government wants to increase the strength also. There is so much of infrastructural development is going on.
Right.
Budget has been going there. So there is a constraint of budget and the workforce also. They have a limited workforce. And there are some rules which cannot increase the workforce also. So there are large number of cases and there are less number of people. So slowly they are trying their level best to do that.
Okay. Now let me directly take you to the very first issue which we'll be talking about right now. It's a very current issue, and there's this very popular petition doing rounds on by, I think, Professor B.K. Rai.
Yes,
you would be aware of it, right?
Yes.
On how IIT administration is filling lakes with sands to build up 10-story buildings, and there are, I mean, I see construction going on everywhere. And have you taken it up, or your team at Hostel Affairs Board taken it up with the Board of Governors or with the director or with whoever is concerned? If yes, what kind of responses did you get? And also, what is your personal take on it? Do you justify it, or you are critical of it? Give us in-depth analysis.
I'd like to give,
because this is something which everyone is very tensed about, when all across the globe, you know, people are working towards making the environment cleaner and greener. We here are making it a concrete setup, right?
I'll give you an idea, actually. What is happening? What is the college? Why he's filling all these ponds, actually?
Right.
Guwahati is an earthquake-prone pond area, actually.
Okay.
So, you have seen in Dibang Hostel, that has totally slammed.
But that is a result of, I believe, construction not happening in a proper way.
No. That is due to this mass land, wetland, this area.
Okay.
So
was it not properly filled up?
No, it was properly filled, everything. So they are filing it with cases. That is a different case, totally.
Okay.
So what is there? The government has asked to increase the strength by 2018. So college is wants to construct infrastructure, hostels, all these things.
Strength by what percentage, if you are aware of it? Are you aware of any of that number?
Approximately 7,000, like that.
Okay. Currently we have 5,000.
Yes.
Okay.
So there are scarcity of space actually. Nobody wants to decrease the greenery. Director sir has once told in SEC meeting also that they don't want to decrease the greenery, but they have to construct infrastructure, hostels, everything for students, and because those will come in 2018-17, like that. So for that, and this area is a tribal region, and still now, if you know that there is a fighting going between tribal people and means land losers and college.
Okay.
So legal fight is going on. So it is difficult. College don't have that much of choice to. They have to fill the ponds, actually. My personal take is that, because I have seen, I know from the administration point of view.
But have you put across any of the concerns from student point of view? Because you are our voice, right?
No, actually, I never raised this issue in this one. This is latest issue, now they are citing the petition.
But I think it does come under the domain of Hostel Affairs, because like everything from pollution to sound, and you know, like right behind Dibang, there's all sort of drilling going on.
But Vice President is the head of everything, so these big problems he will handle, and
it's not under your domain, is what you're saying?
No.
Okay. So we'll move on to the next one in that case. How many GBMs general body meetings have happened since you took the office?
See, GBM is not related to HAB, actually.
I know, but
it is hostel level.
I'm just curious.
Around four GBMs have been happened, and the remaining hostels will do it, because it is ruled that once in a year they have to do GBM.
Mm-hmm. Okay. And how do you try to communicate? Again, I'm reiterating myself that you are our voice, right? There has always been this thing going on for a while that and students strongly believe this at times, ki jo hamare student representatives hai wo student voice hone ki jagah se zyada kai baar administration ke puppet ho jate hain. Ye aapne bhi suna hoga, I'm sure.
Right. People student complain karte hain, allege karte hain.
To ye allegation ko aap kahan tak sahi mante hain? So would you call yourself the voice of the students or the puppet of the administrators? How would you want to put it up?
The so-called puppet of the administrator. It is not that. Because when we go that, we face the reality, actually. Mm-hmm. What is the situation? And when we feel that, no, that is not the situation. We try to convince the student that this is the situation. Yes. And they feel that we are the puppets of the administration. But that is not.
It's just that
because
people are not aware of.
Yeah, that is the, and students are also don't want to know the fact, actually. They just tell and they
disappear.
That's all.
But no. aap sare concerns jaise ye wala,
but it is a totally wrong allegation that we the student representatives are puppets of the administration.
Try to
we try our level best to put our the opinion of the students, the problems of the students in front of administrations and try to get it.
How do you communicate with students? Like, how do you communicate with us, whose voice you are? आप किन means का? मैंने GBM के बारे में इसीलिए पूछा था कि GBM में क्योंकि आपका जो पहला agenda था, that it's related to that, and therefore I'm asking, how do you try to communicate with students? How do you try to know what issues they are going through? Is it just your inner circle of friends who tell you, or you try to reach out to all sections of students?
After every few days, I have meeting with all the hostel general secretaries. Under me, there are 14 general secretaries, and under them, there are six HMC members, each has. So they give feedback and all these things, what are the problems facing by the students, all these things. Good. If I want anything also, I communicate. We have Facebook group, we have webmails are there, and I communicate and we do share our informations. Through them, I get the informations.
So your very first agenda few months, long back actually, a year back almost, was on updating the basic menu system, right?
Yes, yes.
So, उसके बारे में updates दीजिए. क्या हुआ तब से लेके अब तक?
तो
basic menu तो अभी भी basic menu ही है.
Basic menu है. क्योंकि इस बार आपको पता होगा कि इस बार उन लोगों ने tender नहीं किया है. यह तो अगले बार
आप हमारे audience के लिए एक बार उस चीज को बताइए कि क्या situation इस बार रहा जिसके कारण ये चीजें ना हो पाई.
हाँ. तो इसलिए इसको चेंज करने के लिए पूरा सिस्टम को पूरा टेंडर पूरा फिर से लिखना पड़ेगा. उसके लिए हमने फिर से एक कमिटी बनाया है. उसमें 10 स्टूडेंट लोग है. हॉस्टल जनरल सेक्रेटरीज एंड सम आर
ईच हॉस्टल हैज वन रिप्रेजेंटेटिव.
नॉट लाइक दैट, अप्रोक्सीमेटली.
ठीक है.
तो एक्चुअली वाइस प्रेसिडेंट ने 3-4 लोगों को ये किया है और हमने किया है. तो मिलके 10 लोग हैं स्टूडेंट्स में और फैकल्टी लोग 6 हैं और ऐसा करके एक कमिटी बनाया है. और वी आर स्टडीइंग एक्चुअली इन कोर्स ऑफ विच IIT इज विच व्हाट सिस्टम इज व्हाट डी मेरिट्स व्हाट आर दी मेरिट्स एवरीथिंग एंड वी विल कम अप विद देयर एंड बाई फेब्रुवरी एंड वी हैव टू फ्लोट दी टेंडर एक्चुअली सो दैट दे कैन.
तो ये चीज बहुत जल्द होने वाली है. अभी 2 महीने में वी कैन probably get an idea of where our mess system is going towards.
Yes, yes. And surely by our experience, all the persons, student members are there. Those are experienced person, not that simply there. They are experienced person. They know what are the problems. They themselves are students, so they know what are the problems faced by them. Mm-hmm. So you can expect that we are going to solve this one.
Before your tenure ends.
Yeah, before my tenure. That is
a promise.
A promise, yes. Yes. On CBS, yes. Perfect. On board.
Perfect.
Yes.
Let's go on to the next issue, which is the second agenda of second point of your agenda, and this has been troubling a lot of students. You during I remember in your agenda, which I saw recently, you were talking about PG students and PhD students specifically because they get stipends and all of that. But even undergraduate students, many of them come from really humble background, and it's so difficult to accumulate 10 or 11,000 just for 4 months, right? In the beginning of the semester at once for the mess.
Yes.
And
yes.
This was your second point where you said that you would try to make it monthly or bi-monthly, but again nothing happened.
Yeah, actually for that, actually what was the problem when I reached there? Mm-hmm. The automation system of HAB was not good, then not placed. Now it has almost been completed, automation, totally the HAB portal website, everything has been automated.
But
the
it's database. Not yet updated.
Yeah, no, a person has been appointed for that, or doing it, and okay. Our SWC is taking charge of that one to automation. So once this happens, and I like to add here, these students are not good. Like Dr. B.R. Ambedkar said, how good is the constitution if the peoples are not good?
True.
It will not be fruitful actually. And how bad is the constitution if the people are good? Then it will be fruitful. So similarly, how good system, if the, see, before there was this system, 2 months, every 2 months they used to pay the mess fees. But the number of defaulters of the students were very lot. So when the students are not, they are totally misusing the system. The 2 month system was for them, so that it will be benefited them. But they did not pay, they did not obey the rules, and HAB doesn't have that much workforce, and if the students only doesn't cooperate and they don't involve in the system, they don't follow the rules,
right.
Then it is very difficult actually for HAB to do any implement any rule actually.
Okay.
And but to implement such rule, students should be, cooperation of students is highly required actually.
I'm sure it's required, but why penalize the whole student community for, let's say, I'll talk about
No, for that automation is required, total data mess. Every month the HAB portal is not getting updated.
Right.
So there is, people, students are facing problem for giving their feedbacks also. So once this automation of every database and the staff which will take care of this one, making a counting of all the mess works and updating the website or everything, then we can do so many things. It has a very large scope actually. Once the HAB is getting automated, then
so any kind of timeline for such automation and for such process to go on and get live
by February, the work will totally completed. Then the first thing which we are going to do after automation is that we are going to divide this breakfast and lunch and dinner separate actually.
Okay.
Means we will give more flexibility to our dynamic system.
Okay. Which means will the students be allowed to choose their meals?
Yes, means I like to describe this one.
Okay.
Now what in dynamic system, whether they can choose to go to other hostel to eat breakfast, lunch, dinner or eat in our hostel.
Mm-hmm.
Now what you are going to give, because some students are there, they cannot get up early, so to in fear of missing the classes, they don't subscribe to other hostels.
True.
So what I am going to do, I am going to separate this breakfast. If students can eat breakfast in his own hostel and can go to lunch and dinner to other hostel to
Wonderful.
Eat. So what will happen, so much students, those who are not opting for this dynamic system due to fear of missing the breakfast will be able to opt for this dynamic system. If they don't like the mess food in their own hostel, because we are humans and we get bored by eating the same food, they can go to other hostels. So it will be problem.
All right. This would be the first thing that you do after automation begins.
Automation, yes.
But what about the bimonthly since it was in your agenda, I'm really curious, are you going to get it implemented at the end, despite we discussed the issues which you are facing from student community side, from the technical side, but in spite of all this, are there any possibilities of this thing getting rolled up within this tenure?
I don't think, to be honest, I don't think it is, because the practically the clerks, all these things, they are saying that it will be very difficult for you if you this is implemented, the workload of them will so much increase, all these things. So, but we are trying to do it, but to be honest, in my tenure it won't be possible. Once it gets automated, because before that we have to do so many things.
Okay.
The students also should be aware that, and we should form rules also, that if some defaulters are there, what punishment, how much fine it will be there. All these things, after everything, students should be made aware actually.
A little while, so maybe for the next representative you would want to add this as an agenda again, right?
Yes.
Okay. Since it's related to the mess issue, I'll come to this as well. There was this thing that you spoke about, a lot of people here, since I'm now in my final semester, I see this happening a lot. People are really going for gym and going for workouts and going for all sorts of physical activities in the evening, right?
Mm-hmm.
And you spoke about the protein intake within their diet.
Yes, yes, yes. In the committee which you have constructed, in this all the points will
the
be sprouts will
about?
Be yes, yes.
Okay.
In that we have points, sprouts will be included and all the things which
what
are.
What else, if you can elaborate on that, please?
Now I cannot say anything because we have not done a survey what are the merits, demerits. But I can assure that the sprouts has been unanimously accepted by everybody that it should be there in menu. Every day breakfast it should be there.
In the breakfast or during the evening meal?
Breakfast it will be there and evening also you can try it. In canteens, evening in canteens and breakfast in morning actually. Because sprouts should be there.
All right.
And
fine, we'll move on to the next one. So you spoke about the syndicate, right? Run by the food center proprietors and
yes,
how they're
yes,
exploiting
yes.
students accordingly.
Yes, yes.
So you suggested that you would try to break it and come up with the grievance redressal system you spoke about
yes,
for the
yes,
student
yes.
community.
Yes.
So are the things moving on that road?
Yes, yes, yes. We have already almost formed this a committee in which mess coordinators will be there. And there they will decide what vegetables also will be there, they will decide, and quality also they will check, all these things will be done.
Are we here specifically talking about the mess, or are we also addressing the juice centers and the
It is a big committee and a powerful committee. They will take the actually in that committee there will some several persons, local persons, those who will communicate in Assamese in local market, and they can get up to date prices of all these things, so that they will help the committee, guide the committee to fix the prices actually.
All right. Also, this is one issue which I witnessed in my hostel itself, and I would want to discuss this as well. Why are there
which hostel are
from the Hing?
Okay.
Why are there different sorts of menus for the canteens? I mean, few canteens are allowed, or they do serve chicken, which is important and which is nice, right?
Yes.
You are from Brahmaputra, I believe.
Yes.
You guys get biryani and all sorts of delightful things in the canteen, right? Similar luxuries are not there for all the hostels. You also understand that.
Yes, yes.
For example, in my hostel, my warden didn't allow the canteen walas to do that. So why this non-uniformity?
See, canteens, as all we know, that canteens are the lifeline of hostels actually.
They are.
To be honest, and it is very sad actually, but it is honest. It is truth actually. So canteens actually, they have a fixed basic menu actually, means which they have to keep, and there are the rest of the things are optional actually. The optional things are depending upon the HMC and the demand of the students. If there is demand of the students, then the HMC can force them to do it actually.
Irrespective of
there is no wish of the canteen person. If the HMC wants, they have to do it.
They have to do it. Yes. Irrespective of if the canteen guy feels he is not earning any profit out of it or less profit out of it, he's supposed to do it. Is that what you
mean? No. If there is a demand of students, why won't he?
Good enough.
And why, if there is no demand of students, why will HMC force him to do it?
Good. Okay. Perfect. Yeah.
So that power has been given to HMC because we feel that HMC is a sensitive body and
they are
sensible.
And they are close enough to the needs of the students.
Yes. So the power has been given to HMC, and this. And I like to add also, I like to update that administration has rule doesn't permit the canteen people to cook, keep gas cylinders and use them in canteens.
Okay.
So they had already passed in warden council meeting and SEC meeting, everything. So, but we student body has strongly opposed, because we know the once the canteens will become dry canteens, then the students will face so much trouble. So, we had strongly opposed,
thing came from the administration.
Yes.
And were there any reasons?
Yeah, because due to safety reasons, because all the canteens, you know, our construction was not planned for the wet canteens. All the canteens are inside the hostels, and there are some hostels in which the only open space has been being used as a canteen, in old hostels. So the wardens were very considering the safety point of view of students. They had passed this resolution that all the canteens will be stopped. They will be only forced to use microwave and induction heaters, and all the gas cylinders will be stopped from using. So I and vice president, all student gymkhana body, by knowing the grave of the situation, we totally pressurized and we fought and we requested in SEC meeting not to do that. So we successfully implemented that. We were given permission to use cylinders in canteens.
Okay. Now there's this one more minor point which your agenda had, which was actually very useful. It spoke about how, you know, you were wanting to get light facilities for the cycle stands, and even you spoke about
roof also.
The roofs, which I mean, the capacity of the cycle stands currently in the hostels is really less.
Yes, yes.
And this is a very practical fact that if you go in the evening, it's a task to find your own bicycle.
Yes, yes, yes.
But again, nothing happened.
No. Already the works in Lohit Hostel, Brahmaputra Hostel, Lohit Hostel, our Subham Sri, Mary Scholar Hostel, and Brahmaputra also. So, at the end, these three already work has been started. Totally a contract tender has been given.
Okay.
So work will start very soon.
And I think, but the lights can be, I mean, that really doesn't.
No, lights, lights already work has been started in three phase actually. Maintenance section is doing this light, total campus, not only hostels, total campus lightning is. And
which
it has been done by Senate, Senate members has taken charge of this one. All the campus, they have give, done a very beautiful survey, wonderful survey, and they have given the report to maintenance section. And maintenance section is doing the, going to, work out this lighting problem in three phases actually.
Okay.
First phase has already been done, second phase
which
and third phase.
What did it comprise of? Pehle phase
that side, there are so many problems regarding this Subham Sri area and all these things.
They are sorted out?
Yes, yes.
Okay.
You can see that there are lights, new lights. That is in first phase.
This is for our viewers. They should
yes,
know that
yes.
The first phase which included and, the pathway near
yes.
Subham Sri.
And the main credit goes to the girl senator who had done
okay.
the given
so thank
time.
Thank you so much. Alright, so we'll move on to the next one now. You spoke about a multi-purpose complex where, which you were, you said that there's, it's, it was already sanctioned before you took the office.
Yes, yes,
right?
Yes.
And it was supposed to be constructed between Kapili and Lohit, which would probably have facilities which we currently get at the Coca market.
Coca market.
Right?
See,
so,
you raised a good point.
Mm-hmm.
What was the problem? This only not multi-purpose complex and the remaining AC in common rooms and all these things, facilities, lightning in grounds, all these things. All these things were decided in SEC meeting, but in the SEC meeting, Dean IPM sir and the associate Dean IPM sir was absent. So,
do you penalize from there that end as well, people if they don't come up for the meetings?
No, we cannot.
You cannot. There's nothing you can do if from the administrator
no,
side.
No, let me say.
Okay.
So in that meeting, these all were passed. So when I approached them with the list, all the things,
mm-hmm.
they denied that it is not possible. There is so much barrier. They totally rejected the proposal. It is not at all
but
feasible.
But you said it was sanctioned.
Sanctioned in SEC meeting, but Dean IPM sir cancelled that this is not feasible because he was not present in the SEC meeting.
Okay.
Okay. So we felt that. It is demeaning to the SEC meeting actually. Then what is the use of passing it in a SEC meeting? So, with the help of Dean, this one, we requested Dean IPM and all these things to be present in this current SEC meeting.
Good.
So, they attended it. We had a debate, all these things. So, this multi-purpose complex was not passed, but he agreed for AC in common rooms. And lightning in grounds, which he had totally cancelled.
Okay.
So we were successful in doing two out of three. So in the place where the multi-purpose complex was planned between this Kapili and Lohit, there now they are planning to build some air theater or something like that.
Okay. Now the venue for this interview is NewSec, right?
Yes.
You would have seen while coming in that there are a lot of students, girls and boys, studying together here.
Yes.
Right? Sitting on the floor and studying just because they don't have any other place, they don't have an opportunity to go to any other place and sit and relax and study, right? For example, if you go to the libraries, you're supposed to maintain silence there, so you really can't have a discussion.
Yes.
But when we do have common rooms, but then there's a limitation that after 11 baj gaye to didi log ko jana padta hai.
Yes.
Right?
Yes.
So this is really a saddening situation, I believe, because an institute like ours should in any case promote interactions, promote good interactions. And I mean, I want to understand what's going on wrong here. And have you noticed the same?
Yeah, I have noticed it same, though it does not come under HAB, but I have noticed it, I have faced, students are facing
will
it.
Will the timings not come under HAB? I mean, in the common rooms and things like that?
Yes, it comes under HAB
okay.
actually.
Yeah.
But this new SEC building, all these things doesn't come under HAB. But
okay.
I know since I'm a Senate member and we have discussed it because any problem
with student
gets
yourself?
Yes, yes, yes.
Right.
Yes. So, Director Sir has approved a place in on the top floor of this IRCTC and
okay.
it has been work has been started actually. So I have just few days met Dean IPM sir and he was telling that the work has been started. So on the roof of this IRCTC they are planning a get together meeting place and Wi-Fi will be there, everything will be there. So students can anytime go there and they
will
can
will
read.
That be, I mean you would have taken care of during rains and during winter, will that be a comfortable
place to be at? They are totally constructing a proper room, all the things.
Okay.
Wi-Fi will be there and it is good. And Director sir has decided to renovate this old SEC and all these things, and they can also be used for by students for sitting and reading, all these things.
Irrespective of the timings, like after 11 as well?
No, that I cannot comment. I'm not aware.
Have you taken up that issue?
Yes.
Can you give us, because I mean, I'm sure it comes under HAB, right? Of girls not letting go out after 12?
Yes.
Of they not letting go out and study or
you must be aware that one aapki sava also was arranged and students attended, administration attended, and there were discussion pros and cons of this letting students stay out of beyond 12 o'clock. In that meeting it was decided that there are so many demerits in comparison to the merit, so it was stopped.
So there's nothing going on that note. It's stopped.
Yes, but new SEC building and all these things they are planning to do it
all through the night.
Yes.
Okay, good enough. So I find myself really fortunate, you know, to be sitting here and talking to you and knowing about how things are moving on. But at the same time, I feel really not good about how a lot of other students within the community are not able to know these things until and unless we have something like walk the talk, right? What I want to understand is why do we not have an interactive platform? Since you of course work is going on as the discussion went. Of course there are things which are taking place, there are updates, there are suggestions which you want from the student community as well, but there isn't a very healthy or a very strong discussion happening on a lot of issues. People don't know what's going on in the HAB.
Yes.
So why is that happening? Why don't we have an even more interactive platform like the current campus Janta or something of that sort?
Yeah, it lacks somehow in our campus, and campus broadcasting system can play a very important role in organizing like this source and interactive source actually.
That, yes.
So it is required in our campus. But students are not at all involved actually. So I have started so many things like block representatives in hostels so that the problems can be communicated very easily, and they will spread awareness. All the block representatives of each hostel will spread awareness in hostels. Though the general secretary made a block representatives list, but it was not implemented, and the block representatives, students are not at all involved to agreeing to give.
Of course, I completely agree, and this is something where we do lack.
So many things we want to implement, but it is not possible.
Because of lesser.
See, I like to tell you that in a last SEC meeting, this cleaning of bi-monthly cleaning of hostel rooms was approved actually.
Okay.
But
hostel rooms
was approved. The establishment section will clean the hostel rooms bi-monthly, 15 days.
Okay.
So, but I wanted that it should be a culture should be developed in students so that students will clean their own rooms, all these things. Okay, but I did not find that much. This block representatives was mainly done for that one, so that we can, if this system is good, if we get so many volunteers from all floors, then we can do so many things. But that failed actually. I myself failed in implementing that.
So I had to
implement that which was passed actually. That work has been done, and tender also has been written. And in this March month, the work will start.
So we will have hostel room cleaning.
Cleaning,
every
yes. It will be done by the cleaning staffs presently working in the hostel only.
Wow.
And they will get a little extra salary for that one.
Okay.
And it has been implemented. And it has been total, the work, official work formality has been completed actually. And once the tender will be floated in this March month, and you can expect this.
But you do suggest.
But I on my personal level, I wanted to develop a culture with students.
Where students themselves clean their own rooms.
True. But it did not happen actually. So once these students get involved, they know the rules, they want to participate, all these things, they care for nature, all these things, then slowly we can do so many things actually.
Okay. So you do suggest that we need more student participation, and once that happens, a lot of things which are currently stuck can go on, right?
Yes.
Okay. With this, I would want to bring the interview to a conclusion and ask you on what all are you planning to do now that you're just left with the last quarter? All your plans, whatever is going on.
See, and how the can last quarter is the
also,
main.
Also, how can the student community be a part of it and help you in making things easier for all of us?
Yes. So, you know, this is the last quarter and this is the main time when I have to take the fruits. I have planted trees, everything, and now I have to take the fruits actually. So there are so many things which results you will see very soon, like medicinal plants like tulsi, aloe vera, all these things, mint, all the things which I have exploited. All these plants will be reaching by January end, and I have given already the it was in sanctioned. Okay. So by January end they will get it, and all these things, green cycle, I have done it, and you might have known the green cycles, students have been cycles, all cycles, unused cycles has been repaired with the help of welfare board, and have
which is very commendable.
Yeah, and it is painted, and students, those who have don't have cycle, they can use that cycles.
Okay. Will it be on a rent basis?
No, it is free basis, but now we have decided that it will be maintained by HMC. Keys will be locked, security will be having the keys, and they have to take the keys from the security, writing name or all these things, and they have to return the key.
Perfect.
So they all the mudguard of the cycles have been painted by white color.
Have you taken care of all the practical problems which you might be going for? Okay, fine.
Because they may take it outside, so we have painted the white color, so security will not allow those cycles to take out of this campus.
Right.
And students, if they may misuse it and something, so HMC will take care of that one. So we had put lock system. Before we thought that there will not be any lock system, but later on by seeing so many practical problems we may face, so we decided that we will put lock system, and the student who want to use the facility has to write his identity and take it.
What else? Is there anything else which is going to happen?
Yes. There are so many things which are going to be come, like we air compressor pump in all the hostels we had decided.
Okay.
So before we tried in a trial basis on small compressor pumps in Siang, Manas, Subamsri, Brahmaputra, Dihing, but it failed because the small compressor pump student did not use it judiciously, and they spoiled the pumps. So we decided that we should go for bigger pumps.
Okay.
So big capacity pumps. So air compressor pumps in all the hostels, all the 13 hostels has been sanctioned. Budget has been created from technical board, those things, and it will be coming in the January end only.
Okay.
And pool table for all the hostels. Okay, the credit must go to vice president.
Okay.
In talking with the communicating with the sports board.
Wonderful.
And granting it. Okay, so all this time sports board will take consult the HMC of hostels to what the requirement of the sports items in the hostels before giving them. Okay, so we are going for cashless payments in all the hostel canteens, all these things.
Oh.
This is in project by central MHRD has given Visaka.
Okay.
So in that all the gymkhana general secretaries are present members of that one, and under him all these other members, students are also volunteers for that.
Mm-hmm.
So we are going to spread awareness and all these things, and it will be compulsory for stationery, all these things, to use caseless, all these things. So it will be a very good thing, and we are starting this solid waste management in all the hostels, because to care for environment, it is very necessary that we should take care of this and waste actually. So we are developed a committee, formed a committee. I have got permission. We have done the basic research, all these things, and how much waste has been created, all this.
Mm-hmm.
And it comes under 4i labs. We are doing work under 4i labs. So Dean, Student Affairs Dean, has given approval for it, and you can see it being done very soon.
All right.
And construction work and maintenance work of all the hostels, colouring of all the hostels have already been started on red contract basis, all these So already
things
started.
Things are going on.
Yes, yes. Right. So this last quarter, what is the problem that developing a contact with the clerk, staffs, office working staffs, all these things is very important thing in getting things done actually.
Right.
They play a very big role actually.
Right.
So it took me so much months to develop a contact, all these things.
Yes.
Now the getting things done is very easy. Before we used to wait a lot to people. Now we can just call them and just go. So initially it was difficult to start making a bond of these things. Now so many things have been done and we are expecting so many things. All the results will come in this last quarter only.
Okay.
And the things which will be left, I'll expect the my successor will do it.
So any message for your successor? That's what we would want to know, because probably this is one platform from where you can let all those people who are interested in the position which you are holding, in the shoes which you are wearing, to take place and continue. So any kind of suggestions or any kind of promotion for your particular position that you would want to do and would want to let students know what they are stepping into?
No, if they, I have developed such a wonderful relation with the staffs.
Mm-hmm.
I wish the successor takes help of this one, and I will help those children to pass the contacts, everything. I'll build it. So it will be very easy for them.
That's so
but
nice.
It was difficult for me, but I'll make them easy so that they can achieve the goals very easily and they can do it more for the students.
And
well, ultimately, I am going to stay. If they do good, I will also be benefited.
Definitely. And would you want to give a message to the student community on how they should get more involved? And at the
yes.
same time, talk about how, in spite of everything that goes around, our faculty members who are also responsible for a lot of committees as well as the people at the administration are not our enemies but are trying to rather help us. What would you want to tell to our student community in that sense?
The involvement of students is very important.
Okay.
If you want good governance, all these things, then involvement of the students, citizens is very important actually. Once the students, they do their own job and they take responsibility of small things also, that if this there is a problem in our bathroom, sell these things, I will give a complaint to online portal, everything. If there is some problem in our side room, I should inform the particular welfare board secretary, hostel welfare secretary, all these
right.
things, so that they will take care. You should be this helping of one another.
Will make us
yes.
will make life easy for us.
Probably. Yes, yes, and it will help the student leaders a lot to implement
okay.
so many projects.
Right.
Without the involvement of the students, lot of the students, we can do so many projects to show that I have done this, but the actual result will not come unless the students are involved. They have faith on it. They cooperate with the student leaders.
All right. Thank you so much, Mr. Patro, for all your time and efforts,
my
and for
pleasure.
Being our voice. Thank you, viewers, for staying connected with us. We'll have the series going on and we'll have even more representatives coming in and we'll see if they have walked the talk. Thank you.
Okay. Thank you.